and Iyad Ibrahim in Qatar. It is lovely to have you on our live safari experience. I hope you're enjoying sitting with these magnificent creatures and enjoying some time with some very, very cute cubs. Yes, the males will cross borders. Actually, I mean, if you think about it, our understanding of lion territories is kind of like they are pieces of a puzzle that fit together, but that's not the case. So a male lion's territory, hello, you with the little blue eyes, the male lion's territory will encompass the territories of several different females, and the boundaries are sort of human-made constructs, so they might even extend their own territorial boundaries if the other males are far away, and then move away. So they've got what's known as a territory that they actively defend, and then they've got a home range, which is how far they walk. And male lions can have absolutely enormous home ranges that they walk and they explore. And they will also, yes, they will cross into the Kruger National Park. They can cross. These particular males came from not this area at all. They didn't come from the Sabi Sands at all. They came from somewhere further to the north of where we are now. But because this wonderful area is open to several different reserves, there are no fences between them. It means that the animals here can roam as far and wide. They've basically got 4 million hectares, close to 4 million hectares of area in which to establish themselves. It equates to about, what's it, 8.5 million acres. So it's absolutely larger than some small countries, this particular wilderness area, which might not be perfect in terms of returning the wild to what it is, but it's pretty much as close as we can get for the moment. I'm so sleepy. Very tired lion cubs. And Janet, it's a good afternoon to you. Now, Janet wants to know how the little cub with the limp is going and whether or not it is part of this pride. It's not part of this pride. This is the Styx pride. The one with the limp is part of the Nkuhuma pride. I haven't seen it since, well, for 3 or so days, which makes me sound very spoiled, you know. I haven't seen that lion cub for about 3 days now. It's ridiculous. There's lion cubs everywhere. That little lion cub was seen with Brent yesterday. Was it yesterday or the day before? Either way, it was seen. It's much looking much, much better, and it's going to be absolutely, we think it's going to be absolutely fine. Nasty injury, probably inflicted by one of the other lions during the feeding on that buffalo carcass, but we'll never know for sure. But it's going to be fine. It is much better. And sorry, the reason I'm going slightly cross-eyed while I'm talking to you is somebody's been trying to call me on the game drive comms. I'm standing by. Copy him for. I will do. Thanks very much. So that was just Herbert trying to get hold of me and wanting to know, or just letting me know that if we pick up on any tracks that he can follow, then he will be ready and waiting to race out and follow up with the usual dogged determination that Herbert shows in terms of his tracking abilities. He was determined to find these lions today, and he did. So we've got 1, 2, 3, and 4 little monsters. These are 1 and 2. Oh, no, there's a fifth one. I didn't see the fifth one. Okay, in that case, I think we're all accounted for in terms of lion cub numbers. So there's a little one over there. There's at least two different age groups with the Styx pride. These little guys, oh, shame. They seem to be the worst affected by the skin disease. A couple of bald spots, some very scabby ears. Looks very itchy, and I'm sure it is very itchy.